Today's Captain's Blog is brought to you by Billy Dorfner. Captain's Blog. It's 10:23 hours on Saturday, April 30th, 2016. You got straps? All right, you got any beaners?
We're gonna want a couple.
Oh. I was just thinking.
Well, on the plus side, I think we may have gotten enough galvanized conduit to do the master control power line.
Possibly.
All right,
okay. I need two basic kinds of beaners.
Okay. Bless you.
Yeah, so I want to have both.
Just
yeah.
No.
You don't want to grab both? I can't pick this up and take it right out?
No. Easier.
Alright.
Thank you.
Set it over here. No, I don't want to put anything in Bay 1 until we have to.
Thank you. Thank you. It was cold.
Take it right here and back down. Stop. Come up a little.
Not here.
And not fuck up that hinge, it'll be awesome.
Well, that hinge is the white box.
Oh, yeah. It was great. I heard
it.
Mitch, help Jesse tip it up so I don't have to try to prevent scratching as much as possible.
Go!
Alright, you're gonna have to slide it
on. I know.
This is so much easier.
Oh, it's on the forks.
Oh, okay.
Pick it up.
Go back.
Bring it up.
We're good.
Copper.
Down. I'd stand it up and put it over there. This is the bottom of it.
That's the back. Oh, yeah, that's the bottom.
No, that's the top.
Stand it right side up.
This is how they ground the place.
Yeah. Great. Heavy part of the spot.
Yes.
This is the bottom. Okay. Get some let's get some of the
cubes. We put a trunk on the park side.
What gear is heavy as a plane?
This isn't the far side.
Okay. No, one second. Give me a second.
Also, this is the heavy.
Yeah. It's heavy in the back, not the front. All the weights back there was big copper bus bars.
There's no copper bus bars there.
Oh, no, you want to look at here for this.
Alright. We pick up from the bottom. Right.
You're in this side of the box. Jerry, any of you in this side of the box?
Are we going to need to wipe my forks?
Yeah, you want them as wide as you can get.
Megan, can you
take
this?
You want this part back in the box on the fork so you can get.
Stop!
I say there's no way I can reach.
Boom out a little bit.
There's no way I can reach.
That's alright, we'll work that out. We'll stop on it. Just aim for his block. You're not gonna get there, but get as close as you can. Okay, that's all he's got.
Oh yeah, we're on the well can we get the long forks? So we pass the long forks.
This is too heavy for that.
Okay. Well, let's bring the forks in and put it here and see if we can. If we can scooch it, lift it with the forklift, scooch it towards the door, we have another couple of minutes.
Okay.
Back
out.
Just don't fall out of the door.
I'm gonna get out of the way.
My powers are useless here.
You're standing in front of my camera.
I remember we had
DJ.
Damn
it.
Here, Megan, take this a second so I can.
Who holds that next half ton of chain hoist that you just had?
Weighs more than a half ton.
It'll take an hour.
Yeah.
Ready?
No, my health is fucking moving.
You ready now? Ready now.
1, 2, 3. Ah! Perfect. Let's do one more.
Let's not. We'll end up putting it on the floor.
Well, this time I can push it a little bit.
Alright, push it a little bit. Like 6 inches.
Go.
I can push that side.
Push this side.
Okay, perfect.
That's lovely. It's the greatest thing that's ever happened.
1 second, let's just change my life.
I may have just found God.
I thought that was something metal. It looked kind of like all the cat players steal. I was.
Breathe.
Sorry. I got a problem here, man.
Yeah?
Yeah. I had a big fiberglass panel that we tried to pick up through it.
How much further do you need to go to get past fiberglass? Or can you come here side of fiberglass?
That flips up. Oh, it was not this.
Okay. Yes. Alright. Batman. Load shift. Right. Not an inch. Thank you.
Come on up.
Come on in.
Come on in.
Come on in.
You're hitting stuff on this side.
Alright. You steer your side. I'll worry about
it. 1 second. Pull back a little bit, Friday. Alright. Now go ahead. Yeah, that's far as you can get on this side. Oh, okay.
Well, yeah, but the white thing is protecting the block.
Yeah, no, I'm with it.
Alright. I'm gonna fuck this red thing in the middle.
Okay, well, let's just see if it lifts and doesn't chatter.
Okay. Oh, it's going to chatter. Okay. Okay. Alright, you got
your hand.
Everybody take two steps back.
Good.
Bring it outside down the weekend.
Grab some 4x's. I can set it on the 4x's.
Oh,
pick up
some
bottom.
Here they are.
This side
that's,
is
that's
bottom.
The bottom. Yeah. All right.
I can't tell. But here, I'll ask. I'll ask. Oh, you did, okay.
Time is 11:44 hours. I want to take a minute and thank Billy Dorfner, who is today's... Well, we should do it
right. Today's Captain's Blog is brought to you by Billy Dorfner. Billy now we're going to get back to work.
Huh?
Billy Dorfner.
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 Who are you? Where are you from?
From London.
Who are you?
Frederick Bryan.
Okay. You're from London. And you've come here. Now, how long ago did you plan this?
A year ago.
Okay. So, you just happened to show up on the day that, because of a 3-day delay, is the day we're unloading the giant trucks of stuff.
Yeah.
Do you want to kill yourself yet?
No.
You will by the end of the day.
Yeah.
Welcome to the geek room. We're going to get back to work. I'll show you all this stuff later, but it's kind of hard to shoot because we need all hands. So, yeah, we'll be back. Hi guys, my name is Chris Boden. I am a high voltage and energy reader. It's my job. And this is the toy box they let me play with. So we're going to play with a little bit of electricity today. I have three demos at the moment. So let me roll. Anybody right here isn't gonna see anything. You guys will have a good show. Now we're going to do some fun with high current. current is how thick you can make the arc. Now, you guys have all had lectures on don't touch down power lines and all that jazz a million times, or whatever is that? I'm not going to do that because, how old are you? You're 9, how old are you?
No.
Okay. Are you guys pretty bored of people talking to you like you're like stupid just because you're short and young? Yeah, see, that's why I don't do that, because I have the same thing. So I'm going to put on my big rubber safety gloves of science, and I don't actually need these for this. I grew up in a dairy farm, and this is like a comfort thing for me. And I'm going to show you a down power line up close and personal. This is my high voltage stick of science. Get it? Thank you. Now on the end of this, I have 30,000 volts. And it doesn't look like much. That's how far I 30,000 volts can come. That's it. You have to get really, really close for recording. If you watch the tip of my rod, you can see just how close you have to be. You can pull it out a long way. That can get about 4 inches away. But once the arc struck, this is my job. Now, normally this stuff is used for research, engineering, stuff like that. We do a lot of school groups and things like that. But on Saturdays, we have to just play this stuff, which is great. You, with me. Come here. So, this is Helmer, the system here. And I'm going to take a piece of aluminum mesh. Now, the entire audience is going to trust you because you're English. This is, as you're going to verify, that that's just a piece of aluminum mesh. There's no, you know, mojo, nothing. Okay, we're going to load this on the test stand right here. And now we're going to leave out of the box. Take your picture. Okay, the whole world's just not on you. Damn. Oh my god, it's not like you traveled halfway around the world. Just come here and play with this. Okay. Now, I never pick boys for this. This is a girl thing. So you know, so I'm trusting you. You never pick boys to push your big rod onto science because, for reasons we have all understanding, boys want to kill the button. So they go, they're $80 a piece. It's not my first button. So you, we're trusting you. If you screw it up, okay, Second War, Revolutionary War happens because of this, okay. Alright. Now, what we're going to do is take the key from the super secret hiding spot. They had no idea it was there. We'll turn it to R. Now, think of electricity like water in a pipe. Volts is how we measure the pressure of the electricity, how far the arc can go. Amps is how big around your pipe is, or how thick the arc will be. And watts is even easier, it's volts times amps. Watts is the unit of power, it's how far we're going to be able to blast this young man across the parking lot with a fire hose. That's the next part of it. A simple AA battery gives you 1.5 volts at 1 amp, so you get about 1.5 watts. Car batteries 12 volts at a couple hundred amps. A regular wall socket in your house is 1,200 volts. A regular wall socket in your house is 120 volts at about 15 amps. So you get about 1,800 watts out of the socket in your house. This is how you know the guy on Craigslist trying to sell you the 5,000 watt home theater amplifier is lying to you. There's only 1,800 watts on the wall. Right now, we have 1,800 volts stored up. When you discharge that button in a moment, you will output 80,000 amps, which gives us 144 million watts. This will be loud. You know how this is done? Have you seen the videos? Yeah. Everybody wants to watch out there. The piece of aluminum is where the magic happens. Clear fire. See, that's done by somebody who's watched all the videos. Yes, a lot of you, especially over here, will have noticed you felt that go off. That's why we call this project Thumper.
This is the medium-sized one. We have a little baby version, half this size, that we take around the schools. And then we have the big brother downstairs, which is Stomper. This is 144 million watts. Downstairs, Stomper does 1.8 billion watts. You can't be in the room when it goes off. Because it does fun things, like shatters every bone in your body like glass without you being anywhere near. It's just a fun time. So now we get to do something truly remarkable. Everybody follow me.
They're probably more interested in watching them unload our new high voltage unit than me doing the weekly
work.
Hi, kids. Alright, now, this is where we get to do something truly remarkable every week, and it's one of the best parts of my job. You guys have just gotten a tour of the entire building. You've seen all of our secret sauce, every lab in the facility, and all the stuff we do. I'm not just a high voltage, high energy physics guy here. I'm also the president and founder of the company. And at this moment, I'm on live national television, actually international television, broadcast to every human being on Earth with an internet connection. You can tune in totally for free. And they're watching me probably on that camera up there, but it might be that one. They can hear everything I say right there. And at this moment, Melissa is in back holding a camera that is recording and will go out to YouTube tomorrow. After seeing our entire building and all the stuff we do, and realizing that I have no control over who any of you are, you could be West Side barflies and factory rats, you could be billionaire philanthropists, you could be anything. There's only one person in a crowd who I have any idea about, and I just met him about an hour ago. This gentleman over here is on holiday from England. He came over from Wimbledon today. And the first thing he did after walking through the door is we suckered him into helping us unload a truck. Welcome to the geek group. You guys, at this moment, with me on live camera and an uncontrolled, uncurated audience, get to ask me absolutely anything you want. There are no rules to this at all. Usually people ask questions about the geek group and stuff like that, but the idea is this is an important lesson that I do for you and the world every week, to teach people to ask questions and demand evidence of people in power, because I am the president and founder of the company. And if I can get you to ask questions and demand evidence of me, maybe you'll start doing it of other people in power, and that matters a great deal to me because someday you're going to vote. And this is my way of screwing the whole game for everybody else. It's awesome. So, what do you want to know? Just raise your hand. You can ask anything you want. Go.
The demonstration over here, do you ever worry about not wearing an art flash outfit?
For the setup we have going on in there, the only thing that's really dangerous for an art flash type setup is Thumper, and the art flash ain't what's going to kill you. It's the shockwave and the blast and the shrapnel and all that, which is why I stand 40 feet across the room when that thing goes off. It's why I do high voltage and high energy, and I don't do chemistry. With high voltage, I can always stand way away and push a button, and it's controllable and repeatable and safe. It looks really terrifying. It's really, really safe. We've done that demo for 20 years. I don't do chemistry because magic just happens, and that scares the hell out of me. And I'm not smart enough with it to do it. So I do high voltage, and that gives me the lightning and the explosions and the shock and awe. It's very safe and very repeatable, and we've done it a million times. But we have a full set of arc flash protection. I've got a full suit with balaclava, the whole nine. You saw the drawer I pulled the gloves out of. Look at the bottom of the drawer. There's a full suit in there.
Yeah, I've seen the videos.
Yeah, we use that. Like, if I have to do certain things around here, I wear it. But for the Saturday tour show, it's all stuff we've rehearsed, we've drilled, we know it inside and out, and I don't have to worry about it. Next question. You guys are so quiet and so chill. Jesse, can you turn the music on?
Yeah.
Give me those.
You always forget those.
Huh?
You always forget those.
I do forget these. How many of you guys shop on Amazon? Raise your hand. Almost everybody does it, right? Almost everybody shops on Amazon. How many of you know about Amazon Smile? Two guys, and that's because you watch my videos. I have a stupid, easy thing to ask of all of you, and this is just amazingly cool. I want you all to take one of these. Jesse's going to pass them out. This is a little thing, like five-step, five-minute instructions on how to use Amazon Smile. By the way, while we pass these out, if you have a question, raise your hand, because I'm going to keep doing questions for another, like, 5 minutes or so. Amazon Smile is Amazon. It's the same company. They sell the same stuff for the same prices with all the same. Amazon Smile is Amazon's foundation side. And what they do is when you buy something on Amazon Smile, you get to pick any national nonprofit organization of your choosing. We ask that you pick us, but you don't have to. You can pick anybody you want.
and they donate half of a percent, a really tiny amount, of their profit, not your money, their money, to whoever you choose. Right now we have hundreds and hundreds of people doing this every week because it takes you no time, no effort, and doesn't cost you anything, so it's the best way to support a nonprofit organization. And we make about $100 every month. It sounds dumb, but we're just getting started with it. So every week when I do the tour, I pass these out to people, and it's like, hey, it's easy. It's 5 steps, 5 minutes. There's nothing to it. Do this. Makes the world a better place. And everybody likes warm, fuzzy feelings, especially when you don't have to actually put any real effort into it. Next question. Ask me something. Give me anything.
What is your operating budget?
What was last year?
750.
Huh?
Wasn't it 750?
I want to say it was 750. Yeah, about 750,000. And that's all the companies that support us.
I see.
People are on the wall around the corner over here. And we are aiming right now for a 30-30-30. 30% foundation, 30% member, 30% events. But really long term, I want to eliminate foundational support. I hate the grant cycle. It's a horrible way to have to run a company. It's
glorified
banking. Ain't no glory in it at all.
It's hands and knees.
Yeah, one of the first things you lose in this job is any sense of privacy or pride. And we are, as you're seeing at this moment, fanatical about transparency and accountability. The state of Michigan ranks dead last in accountability and transparency of our government. Our operating budget for this, for 43,000 square feet, 25,000 members, 13 million viewers. Our entire operating budget for this is less than the Komen Foundation spends on office supplies in a year. And I see a lot of foundations that get millions of dollars because nobody bothers to read a 990 or somebody's friends with somebody. And I see a whole lot more nonprofits like us that we're making a tangible difference in the world. We're actually doing something and we're broke as a joke because it's really hard to have to beg for money. It's really hard to have to beg for money for education. Everybody, you ask every survey done of every government ever. Everybody says, education, number one, education, education. And then you ask them to fund it. And it just, it's hard. But almost everybody who starts a nonprofit does so because they want to make the world a better place. You know, I want to change the world. I want to save the gay baby seals for Jesus or something. Everybody's got their, I just had like eight of them right there. And almost all of you, at some point in your life, had a desire to change the world. I chose this. I chose education. And the reason I did it is because of that whole logic, reason, critical thinking we talked about a minute ago. Watch this. Everybody right now, in your head, think of any major global, national scale problem in the world. Anyone you want. War, famine, disease, pestilence, pick a plague, anything. Okay, nuclear weapons, whatever you want. Now watch this. I have no idea what you're thinking right now. There's no way I could control that, there's no way I could guess it. But whatever you're thinking of right now, all of you have the same cause and the same solution. Whether it's Ebola and AIDS or domestic abuse or war or anything, they all have the same cause and the same solution. The cause is stupid people make bad decisions and those actions have consequences for everything. And the solution is make more smart people because smart people solve problems and make the world a better place. That's what engineers do. So that's why I picked education. I can't fix war. I can't cure Ebola. But he can. Someday, he can cure Ebola. I can't. He can. So I want to build a place where all of you can come and build the next big thing, the next great idea. I don't care what it is. There are no rules in this building as to what you can and cannot build. This whole facility, every tool you've seen, and there are more tools in this building right now that you can use than Home Depot has for sale in their store on Alpine right now. And you can walk here and use all of them. Everything in this building is for you. This isn't like a museum where it's like going to my grandmother's house where it's cold and it smells funny and you can't touch anything. Everything here you can touch. If you want to learn how to make a giant toy dinosaur, which is, by the way, scientifically accurate, or if you want to learn how to run a television camera, or anything, or a TV station, if you want to learn how to build a TV station, we have three of them. Everything here is for you to use, to tinker with, to make mistakes, to break. That's why we're here. Because if I give you an environment where you can take chances and make mistakes, you can do that here and not lose your house. I set the high voltage lab on fire. If I'd have done that in my house, I wouldn't have a house anymore.
God.
Yeah.
That was a long...
Big mess!
That was a long 2 years.
Big mess. That's why we're here. Any other questions? Go.
Are you linked with the circuit of schools in the area?
Yes.
We bring in or go to?
We bring in hundreds and hundreds of students every year. Not just schools. Youth groups, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, Cub Scouts, church groups, everybody. It's anybody who's got a group of people who wants to come in, we want to host them. We even do weddings here now. Really? That's a okay, see, you laugh, but realize the Nintendo generation grew up and they're getting married now. So they don't want stuffy old church. They want robots and lightning. And we are hosting weddings now. It's a whole thing. And it sounds dumb until you realize that the museum downtown, the Grand Rapids Public Museum, made $500,000 last year hosting weddings. I'd rather make money, $1,000 at a time, hosting weddings, than have to go in, like she mentioned, doing fundraising, where you get somebody, okay, you can get a guy who can give you $5 million, but they want to put their name on the front of the building. No. This is the geek group. It's for us. Go.
One specific question. Hey. I'm a sculptor working wood, but I look at the sanding belts and that, and they're pretty worthless. So who's responsible for...
We swap out the sanding belts as... there are people that do maintenance on tools. Here's a concept that will make sense to you that is a radical new idea to anybody in a room under 30. In this building, you actually have to clean up your own mess.
Sounds good.
It's a radical concept. I spend a lot of time teaching that to people. But we swap out the standing belts as they're used. And if you're into doing wood sculpture, I'm going to blow your mind with what you can do with CNC. It's staggering. To be able to just draw something out and put it into 3D. And we're taking that to the next level. We have a 3-axis CNC sheet router. We also have a 12-foot robotic arm in the other room that we're going to put a spindle on the end and be able to do 6-axis CNC carving of wood, foam, plastic, whatever you want. Within a year, the goal is that you'll be able to walk in and, like, she can stand in front of a 3D laser scanner. We can scan her, and then by the time they go out the other end of the tour, there's a carving of her in progress out of a solid block of whatever. Yes. Well, one of you would be, you know, a little stiff, but yeah.
How difficult is it to learn that?
To learn CNC?
Yeah.
It's not. It's terrifying. It's not hard. My biggest problem is he walks in and he was raised with a computer. He's not intimidated at all.
Right.
And he instantly gets it.
Right.
And I get people your age who walk in and be like, oh, it's a computer. Oh, shit. I don't know. I'm scared. It's a computer. It's a stupid machine that's going to do exactly what you tell it to. And if I can get you, if I can get people over the intimidation factor, it's not hard. You can do it. You absolutely can.
Thanks.
Any other questions? Now, I got two really cool things to show you. I have no idea who you are. And all of you, your entire lives have been led to believe that you are a unique, individual, beautiful little snowflake. And you are, just like everybody else. Now watch this. I'm going to speak two gross generalities. And if I'm wrong, whoever proved me wrong wins $5. Now, at this moment, none of you know what this is, do you? There's your first. Here's the second. You want to, don't you? That moment, right there, you have a sincere and passionate desire to learn, and it's the only requirement to be here. That's all that matters in this building. It doesn't matter if you're black or white or straight or gay or tall or short or fat or skinny, I truly do not care. All we care about is that you have that sincere, passionate desire to learn, and to figure it out and make things happen. Does anybody want to take a guess what this is? You guess right, you get $5. No, but you're on the right track.
Oh.
I'll give you the first hint. You all probably have one of these. Here's your second hint. That's what it looks like when it's doing its job. What is it? CD player? Really? What year were you born? 2003. Tell me everything you know about cassette tapes. Thank you. This is a gas meter. This is what's inside the little gray box on the side of your house. And by the way, if you take one and put it in a totally transparent box and put it on national television, you get to meet all the lawyers at DTE. But this is a gas meter. It's a mundane thing that everybody has and everybody knows, and totally boring, and you don't think twice about them. But if you take a minute and look inside and explore it, they're actually fascinating. This is a rhombic drive, and to watch it work is beautiful. This is an amazing bit of art and engineering that was designed in the days before computers. This particular one dates to...
What did we say, 80-something?
Right? No, this one's 1961. It was made on March 26, 1961. This was designed by crusty old men using slide rules. Any other questions? Then thank you, all of you, for coming and seeing the weird that is my job and all of the cool things we do here. Anybody who's interested in becoming a member, it's horrifically expensive. Last year, membership was $40 a month. This year, it's 20 bucks a month. Because I sat here and just said the only reason it was 40 bucks a month is I couldn't figure out how to get it down to 20. Damn it, we did. Because there are some things in the world that are more important than money. Membership is 20 bucks a month for individuals. It's 30 bucks a month for everybody in your house. Yes, that's the idea. If you're interested in signing up, go over there and talk to the people who will be magically appearing there in mere moments, because I'm going to go yell at them and get them off the back of the truck.
It was magic. Yeah.
You know Mitch?
Yeah.
Mitch is your best friend. I thought I knew all of his friends.
So I met you once. I was here once.
Really?
She was panic.
Okay.
She was panic.
And you came back. And you're a friend of Mitch's.
I'm probably a phone.
Well, you've never
quite possibly, yeah. He set the cat on fire and you're still friends with him.
What?
Only a little.
Wait.
We're no longer friends.
Don't worry about it. The cat's fine. He crawls right back. It's fine. He was welding and the cat was like, ooh, pretty!
It's my cat!
And still most of it is, yes. He's fine!
Okay.
Your cat's kind of a dick. And dumb.
And named after you.
And named after you.
Yeah, that's not weird at all. Thank you, everyone!
Thank you. I'm gonna tip it out. Old deer
board. It's literally an inch.
All right, close the door.
Ready? Get
us some
stuff.
Okay.
Two. Great. This is how you had to do it.
Open the door! Don't everybody help.
Wait!
What's up?
We're waiting.
I can't be the only one over here.
Can this get in there?
We got it. That's why I wanted to see
that.
Okay. Boom. Bring the forklift right underneath. We can set it on the forklift. Bring it down.
Cool.
Someone...
You want to be just in front of it, like 6 inches down.
Alright.
Okay. Look, cut that crap. Alright. Second verse.
Same as the first?
Yep. Pretty, ain't they?
It's nice. Watch them, not me. Watch Jesse.
Point the camera, don't just look at them.
God. Now, walk forward until
they're light. Yeah.
Black.
Ready? One, two, three.
Another 6 inches.
1, 2, 3. Perfect. All right, tilt. Everybody come catch. Catch, that includes you. Please.
Yeah. Door up. Truck, and that's it.
There's nothing left in the cars?
No.
No, we got the cars last night.
Oh, DC coil in our future, right there. Alright guys, time is 16:09 hours. I'm here with Sam. Sam's got stuff. Sam's doing engineering. Pretty awesome, Sam.
I need a caliper, digital caliper with a depth reader. I want to see if Dave has this. The position is set properly.
Yeah.
Or the scale set properly.
This is pretty good.
Because right now I have it set to move one, to jog 1 inch.
Okay.
When it distance move, it will move 1 inch. So our initial plan, we have a rotary encoder.
Okay.
Not an encoder. We have a rotary counter.
Okay. Yeah.
On the travel. We can set it so that every time that clicks once, this will move the distance or the thickness of one wire.
Okay.
So every time it turns and clicks, that will go bump, bump, bump.
This is way cool. I am genuinely excited.
Dave will be pleased to know that we got our hands on a 3-to-1 planetary reducer, which is much nicer than using a 3-to-1 belt reduction.
That's cool. So the next step is getting that setup working.
Which I just need some SO cable and some bonehead stuff and just set it up. But what's going to be more of a challenge is what I really need to do is get this rotary axis moved up to meet with the coil wire.
We've got to totally redesign this setup.
What's this V shape?
Hey, you have to redesign.
Yes, you totally. Sorry. It's all Sam. It's all about Sam. Okay. This is sexy. I like it. So this is one that came in on the donation the other day.
Yeah. I saw it sitting on the floor and thought, that looks exactly what we need.
And then there's your sexy little plate.
Yep.
A Lovejoy connection, and off you go.
Yep.
Cool.
What's this? It's a reset button.
Oh, for the counter. Okay.
That will work perfectly, I think. Yes.
Here, I'll handle distance, that. Let me hand the camera.
Distance move when I say so.
Okay. You gotta be on this side. Because the windows.
Alright, press it. Interesting.
Looks like you're short.
No, I'm too long.
Too long? Oh, you're using it. Okay. Too long by how much?
a really weird factor.
What?
Well, I asked it to move an inch, it moved 1 5/8. So really weird.
That's a weird one. But it just needs work out of calibration.
Alright, press it. Well, I asked to move 20.
How far did it move?
33?
Okay, that's just nuts. So it's a software issue.
Yeah, it's just a matter of setting the scale properly. Which is not really an issue, I'm sure. If you do it as soon as you can connect to a computer, click done. One more time. Yeah, just needs a.
But it's moving. It's working.
That's
it.
That's no big deal.
That's
to do plus. This is going to be the other way. Set go to position, we can set the, let's call that 400.
Take it from like 4 inches off that and 4 inches off this. Bring it right on by. I like the speed of it too. That's really cool.
We'll have to have them bump up the acceleration a little bit because I don't think we have a torque issue. And set the scale.
It's progress! Cool.
Thank you, David, for setting us up with this. It's pretty legit.
Yeah.
And thanks to our sponsors, got us the screw.
I'm gonna send them the video for this. They've been asking about an update, and it'll be nice to have something to show them finally.
Yeah.
That's cool. Thank you, Kane!
To be able to do it on our own.
It's not like...
I've seen it a few times, but...
Well, here, I need the key.
Thank you.
Okay. I think you can figure out where that goes. You're already in charge. Hold that down until that goes to 1800.0. 1800. This will take about a minute and a half. Now you have to do the speech.
Starts out with picture like
picture
electricity, like water through a pipe.
Volts is how we measure the pressure of the water. Amps is how big around your pipe is. And watts is simple, it's volts times amps. Now a AA battery has 1.5 volts at about 1 amp. So you get about 1.5 on the AA battery. 12-volt battery is about 12 volts at a couple hundred amps. A wall socket in your house is 120 volts. 20 amps, so you get 1800 watts. This is how you know the guy trying to sell you the 5000 watt home theater amplifier on Craigslist is lying to you, because there's only 1800 watts in the wall. Now your entire house runs on 240 volts in the US at about 100 amps. And this machine, in a moment, when you press that button and hold it down, then you're there, you're going down there. You got it. See? Okay, you're good. Now, this is where we put these on. You go over there. I have to hold the switch. You don't have to hold anything, so you can plug yours into it. Now, we go to fire mode. When you're ready.
I may or may not have got a photograph of that.
I saw someone put on ear defenders, and they didn't quite appreciate it.
See, the cool thing is, you'll never see, I'll post up, are you on my Facebook?
Yep.
I'll post the picture of what actually happened on my Facebook, which he didn't get. Because what you don't see, and that camera's over here fast enough to get it, is this entire room was lit up right at the end.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And it lasts for half a frame. And I'll post the before and the after picture.
When I was filming, with my camera earlier, I managed to get it, but it was a bit shaky.
Yeah?
So I was sitting off I was pressing the button while trying to
film. I put my legs there.
Oh, I managed to make him make the most horrible face ever today. It was awesome. We're screwing around with the truck or something. He was hanging out. I was like, oh, that's right, we're getting it, bro. And he's just like, oh. What else do you want to say? You can do anything you want. Building chairs. Any piece of equipment, any choice, any of them.
Can you show us the spot?
Yeah. Important things to remember are you don't touch these wires behind you. Now, if you hold this, your left hand right here.
I like him already.
This hand is not any closer here. This is dangerous. Okay. Anything from here out is dangerous. And that stupid dangers! Everything here is trying to learn to kill you. Okay? You don't want to touch this or any other wire. You touch this and concrete floor. Okay? Touching this to here is okay. Touching this to the floor is okay. Touching this to anything else is really bad. And when I say really bad, it's like the Ghostbusters level of really bad. Don't cross the street. Because it's not like, oh, you may tingle, or this may slightly burn a little marker. No. Anything that touches down is like a new I'm driving for this. Okay. Clear? Alright, the white light's your warning. It means it's about to go hot. Okay. It's hot.
Over here and take a picture because his face is worth every minute of it.
I'm going to make you say it for a moment.
Yep. Come over here and take a picture. His face is worth every minute of it.
It's all right.
You are totally safe as long as you don't touch anything.
Yeah,
here. You'll
sure.
notice these are rather warm.
Yeah, yeah.
They'll be glowing red in a second. You ready? Going hot? I promised you guys to look at this. It's 1726 hours, and here's some of the fun that we got. Take a look at these. That's an interesting little power supply. We got 48 of these modules. And the question now is figuring out how we can adapt these for Tesla coil use. Here's some data numbers. Focus.
So are these guys used, are these more resistors or inductors?
What? That's an inductor.
That's an inductor.
Yeah. So there's some numbers. Maybe you guys can find some data on these. I have one sitting out. Here, this is what it looks like up close. I would love data on this. There's the cap data. Take a look. Here's your numbers. And there's three blocks for those. It's beefy. It's cool as hell. And it's screaming power supply. Looks like three phase in, DC out. Let's see what they're rated for and what we can do with them just as they are. I'm interested. Lots of other fun. I'll just get some shots of some tags on things. All this will get inventoried and sorted out starting on Monday. For now, it's just sitting here. Some beautiful interlock setups. This is neat. This is a really cool approach to safety. I like it. We will use this on a project somewhere. Variable tap, inductor setup. There's a Tesla coil in this thing's future. There's another one over here that's a little smaller. Real-time tunable primary mojo. That's going to be fun. Back here, you'll want to see that. Little Variac stack. This is going to be a spot welder. Check that out. There's your maker plate. And it's high voltage in, low voltage out. And what I'm guessing is a set of water-cooled diodes. So that's cool. Bloody big switch. Here's your ratings. There it is from the back. Here. Let me know what those are rated. I'm curious. What?
Check it out.
What is it?
It's a big inverter. Okay.
For the back of my bolt.
Oh, cool.
Plugs in. For like an ambulance one.
Kick ass.
Yeah. Good quality.
We also got a 30-foot blimp. These are the tail fins for the blimp up here.
The tail fins, there's the actual blimp.
Yeah, the blimp's in the bag. So that's going to be fun. We're going to need some big helium tanks. Lots of parts. Lots and lots and lots of high voltage parts. Here's a big power dump relay. Just fun stuff. You guys are going to get to see all of this. We've got to sort it all in inventory yet. Look at that. 10-gauge. 10-gauge. DC Tesla coil. Couple small bits of copper. We got these two tubes. There's my hand for scale. That's a 12-inch tube.
You can see the actual.
Yeah. 8-inch. Here's. Yeah, that's 8-inch tubing. And a couple sheets of copper. Just some small pieces.
Nothing too major.
Let me give you an idea how big this is. There's my foot for scale. And there's the sheet. So, all kinds of fun.
Yep.
All right. Now you've seen it. Time is 23:19 hours.
That sounds made up.
No, really. No. It's made up new every minute just for you. On my stupid watch. So what you got?
I got a lot of stuff in a box. And one more thing. We'll hold that in with tape or something, don't worry about
it. Well, it's great to...
Yeah, it's a feature.
Oh, okay.
Accessibility.
10 pounds of shit in a 5-pound box. So what are the parts, Sam? Teach us.
We have a motion controller.
Which controls the motions?
Indeed. It's the brains of the operation.
Doesn't this want to be like that?
No. We don't have room for that.
But it looks prettier like that.
I know it does. Boxes
that's how they're supposed to look. In fact, usually they're like,
well, go
like
ahead.
Mounting and stuff
Sit
on the bottom.
Back down.
Okay. It's not a problem at all.
No?
No, you cut a hole in the box.
With, oh, hey, it's right here.
Look, see?
This lid.
You cut a hole in it.
Well, anyway, either we need a bigger enclosure or I gotta put it outside.
Okay, I'll contact Stalen, see if I can get a bigger enclosure.
Right.
Because we have friends at Stalen and they make enclosures.
Gotcha.
Okay, they made that enclosure right there.
There's one over there.
Stalen enclosure.
I feel like that one's for something.
What?
The enclosure over there.
Show me.
Let's see from here.
The big box over there?
Yeah.
You can use that.
Can I?
Yeah.
All right.
It's all you, baby. It's all you.
That's plenty deep, and I don't think it's oversized for what we're doing. So nice.
You know what the best part is about it?
What's that?
It's a Stalen enclosure.
This is a nice box.
It's a really nice box. they make really nice boxes that are not cheap.
Yeah. The only thing I'll have to do for this guy is make a backplane for it, which I don't have to do. It just makes it a lot easier.
It's a liquid-tight, non-metallic enclosure. And piano hinge, full gasketed, like it's serious business. In fact, we can make it so people can look it up if they're curious. There's the model of the enclosure right there.
So the only thing I'm unsure about with this enclosure, it's more a principle thing than an actual problem.
You have no principles.
We have a motor driver, two motor drivers in a box.
Okay.
Which usually means it's making heat. This is a fiberglass box.
Not a problem.
It holds heat. So either I can cut big old holes in it, or I know we do have some cabinet enclosure coolers that are around.
The Peltier devices?
Yeah.
We'll cut a hole in the thing and put a fan in it.
All right.
Yes.
We have a lot of money.
Yeah, we are not using it for that.
All right. But we're gonna ruin the IP rating on that nice box.
It'll be okay.
All right. Again, that is mostly a principle.
All of the intellectual property of that box belongs to Stalen anyway, so we don't care.
Right.
It's cool. They got this.
This thing we just powered up a little bit ago.
Yeah.
I have no idea what's going on. We're gonna.
Yeah, it's you need air.
We did.
You need air. It doesn't do it right without air.
We had air.
Where'd you get air?
There's a hose reel over there.
You got the hose all the way over here?
Yeah, just reaches.
Yeah?
Just.
Oh, okay.
This would have been useful.
Well, we got to make a proper reel for that, for the wire that we're using, which will have to be way bigger than that is. That had a lot to do with why it was so big on us building such a beefy mount for it, because the wire spool is going to weigh a few hundred pounds. You surfing porn again?
Yep.
Okay. You want to put that down to your camera?
Sure.
Okay. Thanks.
Yep.
Is
that like you can
hold your voice? Yeah. So we tried this wire. It's much too thin.
Oh, God. First off, don't waste that.
We did not use much.
Okay. Because that's the 32 gauge we use for the lifters. Mm-hmm. And that's way too, this will snap it.
Yeah. It did.
Yeah.
Sure did.
I could have told you that. Because I've made that mistake.
So yeah, I think...
What the hell is that?
I don't know. A guide?
We've had this thing 10 years, I never noticed that part. Yeah. 10 years, and I never noticed that did that. No, it goes the other way.
Sure?
Totally goes the other way. Yep, that looks right. I don't know what it does, but I can tell you that's the way it's supposed to go. Yeah. That's a tension.
It's a bit pressure.
What is this and why does it have three hoses?
It's a motor.
Why does it have three hoses?
So it can go in reverse.
Oh! Okay. Now I'm with you. So one of these is an exhaust and the other two are you put pressure here and it goes this way, you put pressure here and it goes the other way.
Yep.
Okay. So this hooks to a sprocket, a big sprocket, and does this.
Yep.
And it's got reverse so it can go either way. Motors. Alright. So this thing's a reservoir.
Yep.
We've got a filter here. We've got a filter here. I'm guessing this is the big chunky filter, this is a little delicate filter.
No, that's not a filter, that's an oiler.
That's an oiler?
Yes.
That puts oil in for the motors?
Yep.
Okay. And the rest is like stupid simple. What's this?
I believe that is a dryer.
Yeah.
Or maybe not. It's only got one in. Or because it doesn't have, you know, an in and an out.
Yeah.
I don't really know what this is. Normally, dryers have
it this. Looks like a filter. But there's only one pipe. Like, there's... This is a manifold.
This sure... Oh.
Is that?
This sure feels like a desiccant pad. Yeah, I know. So I don't know what that thing's doing, to be honest.
Thanks for the foil, sir.
Yeah, I'm aware of that.
And what appears to be a sock.
It's a, I believe it's a desiccant pack. Give it a feel.
Well, there's no water. It's full of oil. At least, we hope it's oil. You may now be taking part in a government-funded experiment. It definitely smells like oil.
For the people here, about the Mantis Men, you'll know when this starts.
The Mantis Men.
grab a rifle and head on in. You'll know when this starts.
So we still have. Hang on. Look at the bottom. Yeah, one tube.
Yeah.
What the hell?
No idea.
What?
Don't know.
I got it! I got it all worked out.
Okay,
this is my theory. We got an oil.
Yep.
You gotta refill the oil in the oil.
Yeah.
Okay. The last stop before it leaves the machine is here. This is where all the oil, after it goes through the motor, it runs through. This is the oil collection.
Oh, that's a muffler.
Huh?
Maybe then.
It could be.
The exhaust maybe doesn't seal up here.
Okay. And the air goes in the middle.
Maybe.
Yeah, I don't see it because it seals here on the big nipple thing. But coming out, there isn't so much because it's just these holding it in here. It doesn't like.
Yeah,
it
might
be. It's got keys there. But those keys don't actually engage.
Right. Yeah, that might be the muffler. It just gathers it up so you don't have to avoid the mess.
Until Sam comes up with, ah, I'm so...
That is a surprisingly heavy.
I'm growing my muscle.
Yeah, I can go on that. That makes sense.
So, the airline is all the way back over there?
Yes.
Good. I wonder if it's up to air.
Wow.
It needs electricity, too.
Yeah, did you we did that.
Yeah?
Sure did.
Yeah, I like the idea of making the next level frame for it.
Well, let's see if we can get it to run as is.
And then we make it rigid. First we make it work, then we make it rigid, then we make it pretty.
Potentially, yeah. Because okay. I'd much rather make sure everything works before we spend a whole lot of time and effort.
It's gonna work.
Making a frame.
It's gonna work.
Well, is it gonna work as is?
No, we gotta do stuff. We gotta do, like, science, engineering, stuff.
Sure do.
This is going to be our evening. We're just not gonna actually get anything done. We're gonna sit here and look at it and be like, oh, what if... And if all those pieces are still on it by morning, it'll be a miracle. So you guys have fun. I'm Chris Boden.
I'm not.
That's Sam Clark, and that's today's Captain's Blog. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Thank you.
Today's Captain's Blog is brought to you by Billy Dorfner.